All right, we're back. This is day two, and I'm sick as a dog. And my brother said, you're going to be cameraman, and I'm going to slap this thing together. So
yeah, because tomorrow is my birthday.
It is your birthday tomorrow.
So I want to get this done tonight.
So look, you did tighten this top one up there, right?
Here? The pocket where the crush sleeve is, where the wire is going through.
And that crush sleeve is
that's where the original bushing lay.
The silver piece in between was where the original bushing was, right?
So okay. So it has the crush sleeve, so this pocket stays, you know, it doesn't collapse. And then you have the two ears, and I tightened that to the bushing.
Yep.
So those are tight.
Okay.
And then I came down here, and I tightened, because I don't know if we left it off before, but at this moment, we have the lower control arm tight to keep this bracket where we wanted it. Now I'm tightening, I already tightened the lower one here. I don't know if you can see the end of it where the bushing is, right there.
Okay.
So this one is tight now.
Yes.
And so the differential now is sitting square in its bushings. None of that's gonna move at this point. So now I can comfortably tighten these ones, which had the slotted holes in them.
Yes, I remember.
You know, and this now is not gonna move. You know, I mean, that's going to keep it rigid, and then I'm going to tighten the cross member that we cut.
Yes.
And the two new bolts here.
Okay.
Just to put our cross member back in. So, I mean, you know, this one made it easier to tighten with it loose. You know, I could get to this bolt here.
Yeah, for sure. And that was the one where we said, there's a reason we tightened that one.
Yeah, I wanted to tighten that one. And so then I'm going to tighten these ones. I'm going to tighten these ones up here.
Yep.
And then I'm going to put the drive shaft back on.
Okay.
And then I'm going to loosen the control arm bolt. Because the next step is we're going to put the upper control arms in, get all that back together, and put our keys back in.
Okay.
So.
We didn't tighten this one up yet either, did we?
No, I'm going to do that too. Yeah, I'm going to do that right now. Okay. And then I'm going to loosen the control arm bolt. And then that way we were able to work with it.
And I'm looking at this. We're going to want to put that weld on before we put this axle back in.
Even if it was that way, I could hit in there.
But do we want to weld it at all?
We ground the metal down. We might as well. I mean, we're here. I'll just put a little bead on it.
Okay.
It's just for extra, because this bolt in the kit is for if you don't weld it. But
right.
It said, you know, it's recommended to weld, but not necessary. So we're just doing both.
We don't have a stick welder. We have a MIG, so it's really not going to be a deep weld anyway. But it'll be something I can keep my eye on too.
There you go. Yeah. See
if it cracks, then I'll have my friend Jeff Kaplan at work stick it for me some other time. One other piece I did off camera is I threw this control arm on. I'll let you guys see the other side. There was some chamfering that the directions say to do, and we'll talk about that here in a minute. Something real quick, guys. The breather hose for the diff did not fit any longer, so I added a little extension piece and another hose here, so something else to consider. Now you might be able to unbolt it from the top where the other end of this line is and lower it, but it was just easier for me to work down here, so something else to consider.
Click.
All right, guys, I'm gonna bolt this upper control arm on now. And before I can do that, I made sure that I swung the axle back into place. I know it looks like this brake line's really stressed right now. It's not. There's plenty of slack in this. It's not pulling on it hard. And so I needed this pulled. I needed to pull the axle back up into place. So I had to take our blocks out from underneath here, let this swing out, put the axle in. And now what I can do is, as long as that axle stays there, I want to put the upper ball joint in the spindle first so I don't stress this CV boot. So I don't want to bolt this up is what I'm saying. I want to do the control arm first. You put that drive shaft back in the same way it came out?
Yes, I used your paint marks. we'll just not that good.
That's not happening.
What do you need?
A lot more strength than I have.
Okay.
To push this in, I'm just in an awkward.
We don't have the torsion part.
I know. I don't know if the. Oh man.
We might want to put the
I could get it, try to find that bottle back.
That's what I need. I need a third hand.
I'll go. I'm going to go get that jack.
Okay.
Because if we were working the other rack, we could just set the truck down on a jack stand and let it.
Yeah.
But I have a little.
I think we could do it. I think we could have done it without it. Like, I just needed to get this hand up here. Yeah. I just needed to get this hand up here on this piece.
Alright.
I'll just push that axle back in. If you can.
Oh, you know why you're...
What?
Hold on.
What?
Ready for this?
But yeah.
I never loosened the freaking control arm yet.
Oh.
You're fighting that bushing.
No wonder it's so tight.
Yeah, I'm going to do that so we don't fight it. More like, I can't get it.
Well, that's why what happens when you double up on something. I'm like stressing that bushing, that lower control arm bushing.
We almost had it there.
I know. It's still not light. No. No. That's it.
Let me, can you pull that board under it?
Maybe.
Here, watch out. Watch your hand.
Yep.
We're just gonna kill ourselves.
Dude, we just need a third hand.
Huh?
Just needed a third hand to push that control arm down.
We don't have it.
I know. Bottle jack?
Yep.
Okay. Those lights are annoying.
Huh?
Your lights in here are annoying.
Yeah,
I know. Like, I heard it in some of the video from yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The humming,
yeah. I mean, it's not bad, I guess, when you got a car running or something, but... Come on, man, let's just muscle it in. We had it. Big pry bar. You got a big pry bar?
I'm not sure
where
you want
to
put it.
Just to help me.
Walk of wood, maybe.
Yeah, not hold it there? Flip that around like that.
Yeah.
Can you hold it there for a sec?
Yeah.
Put that axle back in there.
Or are we still good on that? Or is that fighting us? Is that axle okay? I need a back.
I want you to lift up just a hair. I'm almost on the ball jump.
Okay.
There you go.
The axle will be fine.
Okay. That helped. I'm just working up too high. I can't get the angle I need from standing on this block. Okay, one, two, three.
Wait. It's gonna roll towards the front just a hair.
What am I?
Well, you're caught on that. Okay, just pause that for a second.
Okay.
I'm gonna find that freaking jack.
Okay. I think my steering's all the way to one side.
You put your keys on, maybe. You might want to get that control jack out of the way. And
I left the keys in there.
Did you?
Yeah. Control arm all the way out, maybe will help me a little bit right now. Can't find it? Here, let me lift that up. That's the ticket. Hold on.
That should do it. I need to lift the control arm up. Put that bad boy in there. Nice.
You're the man. I don't know if we caught what we just did right there. I think our camera was a little high.
Well, the alignment rack isn't the best place to do this.
No. You got it?
Washer, yeah, I'm good. Well, we just pretty much lowered the control arm onto a block.
Yeah.
So we wouldn't have to pour our guts out. Since I couldn't find the bottle jack.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Yeah, cool. You gonna go back up now or?
Snug that up or?
Yeah. Is our axle okay?
Hmm?
Our axle's okay?
Yeah, yeah, but if there's enough to collapse there. So.
What size that is?
Nope.
What do you got in
my hand? I think I need a 19. You got a 19?
At 1 point.
It did. We gotta take that back out. Okay, brake line. Gotta go over top. At least I didn't seat the taper in there yet. good eye there. Okay, brake line up and around the top. Now we're ready.
Where's that quarter pin facing? I'm gonna turn that just a little bit. I hate when the quarter pin goes in towards something.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not turning it like that.
Does that look straight?
Yeah, that'll work. Okay, brake line gotta go over top.
Hold on.
You in?
No, you got it.
There you go. Okay.
Is that the way that goes? Is there a mounting hole for it?
Yeah, there is. Yep, and awesome. There's some hardware for that too, so.
Cool.
Okay.
Alright, let's tighten that up. Make it tight now. So we don't forget about it. We even put the cotter pin in and be done with it.
Yeah.
I think you maybe went a little.
Just a hair.
A hair further.
Did I go too far?
Oh, man. You're using the old one.
No, that's the new one.
What?
It was the new one. It was in, they had it part of the control arm. It was bent a little bit.
Let me give you a straight one.
I think I need to go just a hair more, too.
Yeah, you do have to go a hair more.
I went too far.
No, you didn't. I can see it on this side. You got to go.
On this side, it's too far. Seriously.
Really?
Yeah.
What kind of hole is that?
I don't know. I need to go.
Wait, that's good. That's perfect on my side.
Is it? Not over here.
What do they do? Like drill it from both ends and meet in the middle?
Oh, no. Look at it.
Look at that crap.
Here. Is it good from this side?
Yeah, I'm gonna like right in it.
Oh, yeah.
You know what?
What?
I don't think they drilled it.
They didn't drill it right.
It's not dead center.
Mm-mm.
I don't want to ever crank it.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
So we're gonna see if we can tap that in there, because the one edge of it is through.
It'll go. I think it'll go.
I didn't have a freaking sledgehammer.
I don't think I was drilled right through the center.
Do you happen to know if these ball joints are replaceable?
They are.
Like, do they give you
a... It says in the kit, I think it's like Ray Bestis or something. It was a... Definitely a replaceable ball joint.
Awesome.
You see the snap ring that's in there, too. That's goofy, man.
Can you pick that from up this way?
I mean, pull it through.
See it.
The heck?
I don't know, but I think the cotter pin shot's going to be the other ball joint. Okay, you're in.
Okay. Paradise.
I don't want to put thumb or tighten them up yet.
No?
Because if we need to get to... Well, no, we could probably...
Oh, shoot, I forgot about that.
I think I could get on there with a regular Allen. We're good.
For the weld you talking about?
The weld I can do.
With the axle in place?
Yeah, that's not a big deal. I was talking about the Allen head for the...
Oh.
Let's just put the other side. We'll worry about the... We'll worry about... Let's get the other side in.
Okay,
we'll
yep.
Get the shock mount off that we never took off the other side.
Okay. We didn't take this shock bracket off yet on this side. We took the other one off. Would have been easier in hindsight to put that back on with the whole spindle and upper control arm off, but
you know, it is what it is.
So in this step for the upper control arm, they're having you chamfer the pocket for the upper control arm bushing. And we were wondering where you were chamfering because it says for clearance purposes, but they're just showing you doing it on the side. And I think that's just so you can get the control arm into place better. Cause it's a little, it looks like maybe just a little bit wider.
Yeah.
But we didn't have to do that. So I'll show you this side.
Yeah. But we're going to handle it. The bushing is actually wider than the rest of the control arm. So it's not going to hit
right. So I need to show that, but we'll figure out which way this shock bracket goes here first.
75%.
Somewhere. Okay, here. They show a picture of it. Figure three, a long time ago that we skipped. So it looks like the tapered part, so have the tapered edge facing the brake rotor.
Is that the rotor right
see,
there?
Yeah, there's your axle. There's your lower control arm. That's your caliper. So
that would have been the opposite way I would have thought, but that makes sense. So this way.
Yes. Is there a nut on the other side, or it's threaded?
Threaded, man. That's why they don't want you to break it.
Oh.
So I'm seating them, and then I'm just gonna make it a little bit thinner type.
Yeah, gotcha. Cool.
Cool. All right.
So, all right, well, we need to show the control arm part that we skipped on the other side.
The chamfering part that they showed, and it says for clearance purposes, but you see the bracket, that it's pretty much hitting right there. So I believe they want you to chamfer the edges here and here, but we don't need to. I mean, honestly, I can put the control arm in and just tweak it a little bit. Same thing on this side, because that once you tighten it up, it's gonna pull that back, you know?
Yeah, and the less metal you take out of the truck, the better.
Sure, I mean, that's what I did to get it lined up on the other side. A little bit.
Once we get it in there and we stick the actual bolt in, It has full range of motion anyway, right?
Yes. Not like... I'm going to show that. So there, no chamfering needed. And let me put the bolts in and then I'll show you guys the full range of motion, that there's nowhere that this control arm is going to hit. So I really don't understand why they would want me to take metal off.
Yeah. Well, I mean, chamfer is just cutting the edge off. So yeah. It's not going to help anything but
yeah.
to install, I would think.
Right.
You know, I mean, if yeah. they had you knock a chunk out for clearance, then you're worried about it
sure.
hitting.
But yeah.
just to taper the edge, it's kind of like, how many times have you done that trying to put a bushing in? You know what I mean? Like get it on the grinder and just taper just the edge of it
yeah.
so you can get it started.
Right.
You know, and then yeah, that exactly. part ends up sticking through the other side anyway.
You need a ScannerDanner pocket screwdriver.
Yes, I better get one.
You will once their production happens.
I'll make sure I leave it randomly, you know, on my jobs somewhere, you know, in film. Like there's this one video, I have a cigar, like just like the edge of one I was chewing on for a while.
Yeah. And,
I saw it when I was making the video, but I was like, you know, I don't care. And it took a while, but someone finally said, you know, is that a cigar? So someone saw it. I'm like, it took a while. I was like, yeah, you're the first one. Busted.
Where did you have it sitting at?
It was like sitting on a battery or a radiator, because I was talking and I noticed that I was like, you know, talking with a cigar hanging out of my mouth.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, that doesn't sound good. So I set it down. And when I started filming again, I didn't remember where I put it. It might even still be on that car, for all I know.
Get on there. Is this bent?
Yeah, you just probably need to like get it in the perfect part of the slot.
Right.
You know? You got the wrenches for that?
No.
Those were the 21s.
The 21?
I don't remember, Danner, honestly.
Paint looks like mil-spec upper receiver paint.
It's like what? See your pocket screwdriver again.
Like the AR upper receiver.
Oh. I need that, what do you call that thing?
A lady slipper.
Lady slipper, that's the word I was thinking, but I didn't know if that was the right term.
I don't know, that's what they taught me when I was in Rosedale.
It's called a lady slipper.
I don't know. Show it. It looks like it could have a, you know, that's the first thing that I think of, huh?
Too far, damn it. Definitely would have been easier to go inside out with these, but if you're confident, it doesn't matter, they're pinch bolts.
But I'm pretty sure that's the way it was.
Okay, and the setting for these guys, they want you to put them in the center as a preliminary before we put them on the put it on the alignment rack.
Okay. Just make sure you can move the control arm good. We'll tighten it once it's settled.
Yeah. Oh yeah. We gotta. I meant to show that part before we went any further. That's still moving. I didn't get tight enough on this side.
Yeah.
See if I can show this. The distance with my headlight on there. Can you see that part good on the camera screen right there? You see that okay?
Let me flip this around.
Right in here?
No, here. There you go.
So there's perfect clearance on here, all the way up. Okay, nothing hitting here or here.
Uh-oh, I have your camera.
Yeah. Or here. And if I push it all the way down, I'm hitting this jounce bumper, I think that's what it's called. Nothing hitting on here at all. So the only reason they would have you chamfer this would have been just to get the control arm into place. And we did not do that. This is way loose still.
So when he gets his vibration analyzer tool for a squeak, and you see it where it's coming from.
Yeah, right? Let's hope not. All right, let's get this part back together. Now we're gonna
I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna raise it up. I'm gonna take those blocks out of that side.
All right, let's try to show that part. Yeah.
I went all the way to the edge of the control arm and not under the ball joint.
So with our blocks of wood down, I'm just that's fine right there. All right, so again, the brake line, it's got to go on the inside. I'm not worried about my ABS sensor right now. You see why I had issues with the cotter pin? They had it in there.
Oh, and bent already.
And bent already to hold the nut in place.
Weird.
Where's those dykes at? On that side still? Yeah, I guess so. All right, so brake line goes on the inside of this. All the grease from my other one. Oh yeah, axle, important piece.
You
mean
to come down a little more?
I can come
down a little bit.
Yeah. A little bit more, if you can. It would help. Okay, good. You got it?
Yeah, but you know what? I want to spin that one again.
Okay.
Same thing as last time. It's facing outward.
What we're doing, guys, is we're just rotating the ball joint just so we don't fight the spindle with the cotter pin. Okay.
That's one of the same ones when you have it tightened into this taper and then you notice it later, you're like, oh,
yeah,
man.
Right.
Which usually isn't the end of the world, but then if you ever have to take it out, it's worse.
Wait, our axle fell. Can we get that in without? Yep. Oh, cool.
We're good.
We were actually able to get the axle in on this side. I'm wondering if we could have done that on the other side too. Don't know. With the ball joints in place, we're actually able to slide that inner axle.
We still are hanging pretty low too, though. Who knows?
Oh yeah. With like the natural ride height, or if the torsion bar keys were in or something. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Might not be able to.
That makes it make an axle swap easier, you know what I mean?
Sure.
Take that out and you can just swing it down. I think the main reason to do that part first was just so when it flopped out, it didn't pull on the boot, separate the joint.
Right.
That one looked like it's drilled right.
Not sure. Never want to back off one of these nuts, guys. If you ever using one of these castle nuts and your cotter pin is not aligned, never back them off. Always go one tighter. And that's the rule with these.
And if you don't think you can go one tighter because you already went too tight, then you need to do something with a washer. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Underneath it.
Yeah, that one was drilled right.
Nice.
So that one ball joint on the other side, the drill was offset and had a little issues with the cotter pin, but we'll be okay. Sorry, my shoulder's in the way. We'll skip this part, I guess.
Those left and right, are they the same?
What's that?
The control arm.
I'm hoping they're the same.
I mean, it has like a universal tab on either side. They look the same.
I put them next to each other and they looked identical, so.
Did you look at the packing sheet? See if they had the same number.
And I didn't. Should I have?
Maybe. Before we keep going too far.
Well, I did try to fit them both.
Did you?
And they both fit.
They look the same. I'm just wondering, you know what I mean?
Well, we should probably check that. It's a good question.
Look at the front page. Does it give you like two of the same part number, or does it say L and R?
Upper control arm assembly 2. It just says quantity of 2.
Okay, cool.
Cool.
That's the.
All right, what are we doing factor. Next? Are we bolting up the.
I would say let's put the axles on.
Axles and brake lines.
Get all the brake lines together. Get the.
Okay.
Get the.
And we did have some.
Well, we got the shock on this side. We can slide the shock in too because we're. We got when we put weight on this, it might be easier. That might help us put.
You want to put the shocks in now? Let's do the brake lines.
I don't know, man. What does the pamphlet say?
I don't know. This part doesn't matter. Let's put our brake lines on. All right, so they gave you some self-tappers that go into the brackets here, guys. So pretty straightforward with the brake lines. That brake line is tight. Okay. I bent the bracket in a little bit. That's better there. Again, that control arm's hanging right now too though, so. All right, I think next step is what? Bolt the axles in and do the shocks?
Yeah, see if you can get that bracket on there without fighting it too much, because I don't know.
Oh, the shock bracket?
Yeah, because I didn't do that side.
Okay. What are you grunting about over there?
Just
shock. You say the shock?
Yeah.
Need help? Boy, you'd be screwed if you broke one of these bolts.
Yeah, you'd end up needing a control arm.
Okay. Let's go over on the other side and watch it.
Don't watch me.
Watch Danner struggle. As you guys are looking at this shock being installed here, you might be wondering,
why am I using a pry bar?
No. Why I'm not using those rubber boots that came to me in the kit. Actually, they were ordered separate. I wanted to have them, and I talked to Chris from Rocky Mountain Suspension, who's why are you kicking my tripod? Who suggested that I don't use them, surprisingly. I mean, it's a product that they sell. You know, why would he not want to sell them to me? And the reason being is what they have found is when you use those boots, it traps all of the moisture and contaminants in that shock area. And actually the shocks fail more quickly with the boots. He had mentioned that if you look at all the off-road guys, when you look at their trucks, they don't use them. So I thought that sounded pretty legit. And so yeah, I'm not using them. We need to lift that control arm up, right?
No, I'm actually, this thing will shoot down. That's what you heard me grunting.
I was you were trying to push compressing it up, the shock.
The bracket that I'm trying to put it back in, they give you the bushing.
Yeah.
And they give you the sleeve and the bushing. You put the bushing in first and then the sleeve, but it just seems like it's just a little bit wider than I'd like it to be.
I gotcha.
I'm trying to spread the ear up and see, watch. See, I definitely have enough. See, okay, how I gotcha. Pushed down the way. But now I gotta do that again. It just doesn't want to go down in there.
It's fighting the shock. Nice. What was that?
The upper bushing that wasn't tight yet.
Oh.
That's why I was trying the bigger lady slipper.
Yeah.
To try to pry that apart just a hair.
And it's a real thick sleeve too. It's not like there's any give in it. That piece that we bolted to the control arm.
Yeah, yeah. There's not a lot. I mean, I'm close, but if I can tap that sleeve over there. There we go. Now here's a question.
Yeah.
We reusing bolts? Your old shock bolts?
No, I think I have bolts. I'm gonna have to reuse my old ones.
That's a substantial bolt.
Not the case for the top. Right, the top, they obviously gave us a new.
Yeah, but I lost my nut.
Oh. All right, so we're reusing the shock bolt. All right. The lower shock bolt.
The lower shock
bolt. All right, so we have the shock in on the other side. We have the axle bolted in on the other side. This side, I'll show you guys, I'm just using this little lady slipper here to line the axle up. And then bolting this up. We got to put the shock on this side, and then we'll put the keys in, the new keys, and then we'll, I guess we'll be starting on the rear here real soon. The rear is going to be really easy, just a couple of blocks and some new U-bolts, so it should take no time at all. You know, I wonder if the electrical part to the axle, I didn't check the distance of that. I had issues with the vent line. Stick this in the rotor. All right, shh, be quiet over there. Guess we're gonna have to set this part to music. Huh? We're talking about ammo and
that's cool.
Guns. All right, what we're going to do now is we're going to put the tires on, the front tires, before we tighten this lower control arm nut. That way we're sitting at the normal ride height. And we need to put the keys in too. Before we put the tires on, right?
We'll put them in and get them like Saturday.
All right, so right now we're going to put the keys in first before we put the tires on. Everything else is tight. The shocks are in, brake lines. What else do we do? The axle nuts, they're done, both sides. Oh, we got to plug in my front diff wiring. See if that plugs in for me, Danner, since I'm holding the camera here.
Yeah, did this piece snap into here by chance? Did it snap into
like there? Sure.
It looks like it would have.
The harness up top, yeah. Looks like we have enough.
This thing, did it have like some kind of
No clip.
Tie or something?
Nope,
or,
just plugged right in.
No, I mean to hold it away from the steering.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, there's one of those clips that, like, wire loom clips back there. So I'm not sure if we have to do something with that or not. I'm going to put my head in your way a second.
Well, plenty of harness, though.
Maybe. Well, I snapped it in up top. Maybe I shouldn't have put it there. Making me fumble. Okay, that's plugged in. Now, I see up here. I snapped this in up here, but I don't know if that's where it was or not.
I don't remember unsnapping any of that.
Because there's a little pin here. But we'll
it
leave.
Looks like that's where we'll go. Put it there.
Yeah, but it looks, but see here.
Oh, yeah. But we don't want to hit
you
that.
You know what? If it went in here, look, it went in your differential right here. See that? Can you go where my flashlight is? You see that hole right there?
Maybe.
My guess is you got to move this over because we dropped the differential. But do you see that hole where my finger is?
With that finger right there?
This one that's moving.
Okay,
that's probably where this thing plugged in before, but we got to move it down a little bit because...
Okay, yeah.
But back in here, can you get up?
Yeah, kind of.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Maybe have a wire loom clamp right there. So that's going to keep it away from your...
The steering
components, and then I'll just see if I can slide this down to here, and then we'll snap that.
Okay, yeah.
There.
Sweet.
So now we're
away
totally out of the way of the steering. You don't want to leave that loose because someday you won't have four-wheel drive when you need it.
And again, what we're saying for anyone who's doing this in the future is it might have been helpful to take that steering arm off, but we were able to do it without taking it off. So your call. We certainly had to cut that one bracket to get the axle out. So.
Yeah, without it being dropped.
Yeah. All right, going after the keys now. Yeah, I mean, we did cover this before, but briefly, we're just putting the keys back in. We talked about angles. We talked about, you know, it being down too far, which is not really, pretty much foolproof.
Hexagon, you can't mess it up.
Right.
You know, you're going to put it in. Yep. You can see I'm almost level here.
Yep.
It's either going to be down here or way up here.
Yep.
Is it going to work?
And I want to add one thing here. What for this kit.
Oh, it's junk now.
For this kit, I want to add that I had to actually give them my RPO codes because there were differences in these keys depending on what torsion bar was in here. So maybe it's something to point out for anyone.
I didn't know that,
for anyone using this kit. And what I'll do is I'll actually put the description. I'll put the link to the kit that I'm using in the description of this video. So make sure you guys look for that. Because offhand, I don't remember which one it was, but I think it was around $850 or $900, something like that, for the whole kit for everything. So, pull that back out. Yeah, put that back in now.
You just want to make sure that you have the. You have it sitting in the notch.
Yep.
Is that coming through clear?
Yep.
You don't want it off-centered because then it'll pop on you eventually or wear something out. So you want it that. And then you can actually safely drop the... if the tool is in your way, you can actually safely drop the torsion bar.
Yeah, because you're resting on that piece.
And rest on that piece.
And there are ride height measurements in this kit that they gave us as far as what we want our max ride height to be. It says if you go over that, you know, your handling of your vehicle will be affected, which makes sense. I'm not sure we're necessarily going to be doing it that way as much as how it looks. We'll see.
Yeah.
And before we adjust these, of course, we're going to have this.
I'm going to run them about halfway.
Then we'll have the tires on.
And then another thing is when you want to raise it, it's easier to raise the car up under the frame
of
the truck, unload it, and then you can turn these real easy.
Gotcha.
Because if you try, you could. I mean, but you'll sit there and, you know, pull your gut out trying to crank the truck up. Why do that?
For
lift it up under the frame and
that makes
and
sense.
Crank it. you know, and then set it back down.
I think I remember doing them at normal ride with my tires on, Dan.
You can, but I mean, if you're going to go like 10 turns,
oh, yeah,
it's easier just to take
it. Sure.
What are you doing?
Just so you're not there all day.
That's all. This isn't the fine
tip. Here, I'll hold the light.
There you go.
So I didn't get any of that.
Well, I just pretty much have the bolts just sticking down a hair below.
You got an
inch of thread left.
Okay.
And if you want to shoot up through here, the max, you're going to hit, if you take this all the way up, chances are the torsion bar key is going to hit the top. So you're...
It didn't before.
No, but it will now. You've got the offsets.
Gotcha.
I mean, well, maybe not. You know what I mean? Okay. But there's a good chance that you might. So you're limited to how high you can go with just going this way.
I think you should take it up to the end of the white threads. You see the white... Yep.
Right there?
Yep.
Yeah, you can see where it was probably Loctite in the factory.
All right, let's go with that.
So I bet you already got a little bit of a lift right there.
All right, I'm going to get out of here. We'll put the front tires on and drop it down, and then we'll do the rears. Okay, a little dilemma that we knew we were going to run into is getting the tire back on. On this lift, we are already jacked up all the way and I can't get the tire on. So we're actually gonna loosen the torsion bar again and maybe that'll give us, cause it pushed it down, maybe that'll give us enough to get the tire on. So go ahead.
Can you see it?
Maybe. Yeah, it's working. I'm close. Oh, I'm right there. I'm on.
I'm totally out. did that really do it?
It totally worked. Let me get a couple of the lug nuts on.
We can get a 22 for that.
Yeah.
That's funny.
You got a 22? I might as well put them all on, right?
Yeah.
We're not taking this wheel back off, are we? 140. 150. Whatever.
No, I think I have 120.
220, 230, whatever it takes.
I got the 140 torque tube.
That was a Mr. Mom.
What was it?
Reference. Remember the movie Mr. Mom?
Yeah.
His boss comes in at, he's like, he remodeled his house and he asked him like what wiring he used and he's like 220, 230, whatever.
Well, I do have the 7/8
torque stick.
140, are you in there?
Yeah, yeah.
140 foot pound torque stick.
Do it up. You trust those, Danner?
I do. You know, I check them all the time.
They're good?
Because Joe always likes to retorque stuff.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Joe, it's auto perfection. Come on, we'll go around the block once, we'll retorque it, and then we'll put this sticker on there that says retorque after 100 miles.
Yeah. Nice.
But I do. Like, we'll torque them with a stick, and then we'll go around, and usually, let's say it's an 80 foot pound torque.
Yeah.
I'll go to 85.
Yeah.
And I'll feel maybe one nuttle. Nice. You know what I mean?
Cool. Yeah.
You wanna watch it?
Yeah, go ahead. I'll just keep my camera still and we'll watch this side. Raise up.
Going up?
Yep.
They have an issue on this. Oh, nope.
Sweet. Orange one.
I was gonna bring my 32 inch tires, but I figured.
Yeah.
We'd be better aligning it with these smaller ones on it.
Yeah, I can mess up your stock rim.
Well, we can get to the control arms easier with these smaller tires on it.
That one's right. In further.
Huh?
The driver's side's in further than the passenger side. That's probably okay.
Come on. Yeah.
No, that's probably okay. This thing looks like it's pretty. This thing looks like it's jacked. Like, not jacked in a bad way, but I don't think it's gonna lower much.
It's gonna lower some. I mean, Yelly, we probably only have like an inch and a half in it right now.
Yeah, I can't tell right now. We'll be able to tell when we get the rears in to see the difference.
We'll put it this way. Even here, I only had two blocks before.
What's that?
I only had two blocks here with maybe room for a 2x4.
Okay.
And I didn't triple block it because I didn't want it to fall over.
Yeah.
But it, you know, I mean, just from where we set up before.
Yeah.
We could measure it real quick.
Nah, it doesn't matter, man. Let's get the rear blocks in and then we'll get some after shots in a minute.